Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Rhodes House. My name is Christian Nattiel. I'm from St. Pete, Florida, and I'm a member of Linacre College. I'm lucky to say that I'm a married man, and my wife, Zaniah, is here supporting me today. Thank you. Another thank you goes to Nadia and Ngoni for allowing me to share my thoughts with you all on such a special day. Today is, amongst many things, a day full of mixed emotions for many of you. Some of you come from places where Oxford's prestige is merely a different page in the same chapter of life, while for others this place can seem foreign and palatial. To some of us, none of that even matters because of historical wrongs that have yet to be redressed. One of our trustees, Andrew Banks, recounted his experience at Oxford 4 decades ago to being like a strange man in a strange land. I get it. No matter who we are, we Rhodes Scholars each face both expected and unexpected transitions while we're here. And despite the resilience we may all have, these unexpected transitions may prove to become formidable mental and emotional challenges over the course of our experience. Now, I'm not here to just talk about the importance of mental health or some other trending buzzword. I'm here to talk about fostering a community where we associate strength with authenticity, vulnerability, and social support. For me, I'm a U.S. Army officer who just left a country where the populace repeats, "Thank you for your service," whereas now I'm in a place where some people think differently, where they think we're just murderers for Trump. My undergraduate institution, West Point, a full-time military academy, was a place where everybody was on the same team and we had a very uniform set of values. Yet Oxford is a place designed for freedom and independent thinking. I had my whole life planned out in detail until 2037, but this opportunity is just so complex that I started to question each ambition I so confidently had. What was right was unclear on the good days and just wrong on the harder ones. The bottom line is that I had to reevaluate who I was without my uniform on. So who am I? I'm a black man who was entrenched amongst a close circle of friends whom I identified with, yet now I'm living in the older, posh side of town called Jericho, where people don't look like me. Furthermore, I happen to be the first black graduate from West Point to win the Rhodes Scholarship. But I don't mention that to self-aggrandize. I say that to explain that for a moment, it felt like there was no mentor out there who really understood this experience for me. I went from being unnaturally busy every day with virtually no alone time to feeling isolated here with only 8 hours of class a week. And underneath that, there was this pervasive feeling that the more I assimilate into this community, the less relatable I will be to my own community back home. The people who I said when I wrote my personal statement that I would one day be a change agent for. Keep digging, and then there was this feeling of fraudulence. Since it took me a few times to get admitted into Oxford my first year, it felt like I'm thinking all of these thoughts as I stare in the ceiling at night for hours for something that I didn't even truly earn. As self-aware as I thought I was, I had to turn to writing to make sense of things. And so what did I learn? I learned that we each come to Oxford from contexts that you could think of as your own little snow globe. Yes, some of us are well-traveled and we're all well-read, so we know that the world is bigger than ourselves. Even still, give me the benefit of the doubt for just a second. It's not just a snow globe in this physical sense of the word, it's a snow globe of values when you consider just how international of a place that Oxford is. During your time here, as you encounter these transitional challenges, Oxford sort of shakes your snow globe up. First, you'll recognize that there is a glass boundary to your snow globe, that there really is a world of values outside of your own, and then you'll permeate through the glass into the ether of your communities here, where you can wander and peer into other snow globes around you, if you so choose. Your growth here will be one of self-awareness and expansion. And your first year will likely be marked by just that permeation process, and it may cause for some emotional bumps and bruises. What I challenge each of us to do, however, is to foster a community where we do not feel weak or inadequate because one of us admits that they are disoriented by whatever their specific situation entails, their strength and vulnerability. And I know some of you may feel that you need to keep up a certain reputation of perfection to capitalize on the next opportunity, and therefore you'll just manage alone. I tried that, but I took for granted the setting that I was previously in. Up at West Point, I was with a certain group of people every day, and no, I didn't vent to them all the time necessarily, but my point is that I was in a setting that I was entirely comfortable in, with people around me who understood me, for the most part at least. And here, however, we have to make that community for ourselves. In my view, a step towards true and meaningful connection with each other is the establishment of a shared identity. And I'll concede that it's not my place to determine what anybody's identity is, as I'm glad to say that our cohort is one of beautiful and remarkable difference. We're in a diversity that makes us all better. Even still, I can say that we're each going through transitions and trying to get new bearings on a map of life that's about to get redrawn. All in all, if we want to manage these transitions smoothly, we need to be strong, but we can be even stronger together. Thank you.